Hey, it's BGV, and welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to a sneak peek of Skyrim Special Edition, or Skyrim Remastered. Bethesda sent this game over to me really early, and I was able to produce some content for it before the embargo date, which is the 21st, and then, of course, the game releases on the 27th. So, I hope you guys enjoy some gameplay and, the ability to look at how the changes affect the game, etc., etc. One thing I did want to mention that I noticed after I ended the last episode is that I went into the save, and I saved right here. Look how fast this is, guys. Instantaneously. It's just like PC. However, this is at the beginning of the game where the game doesn't have to deal. Okay, Roloff. Roloff. I'm just trying to explain things. So yes, a very fast save, but of course this is at the beginning of the game when you don't really have to deal with a lot of information. So I've gone ahead and made sure everything is good, all the settings and all of our equipment. We're using an axe, and some flames. We also have healing, of course, and battle cry, which is the Nord power. And just in case you're not aware of that, if we go into powers, we have Battle Cry. Targets flee for 30 seconds. That is the unique power that Nord start off with. And also, if you were unaware, they also get Resist Frost. Your Nord blood gives you 50% resistance to frost, which is really good considering frost magic is utilized against warriors to slow them down, and it really is quite effective. And because we're going to be playing a Nord warrior, that is quite good. But it's not like we can really change it or anything. You have to have it. Oh, those guys are dead. How many times have I witnessed the death of those two people down there? Was it two? Was it more? Damn, not really sure.
That dragon doesn't give up easy.
Yeah, well, it's a dragon, Rayloff.
Grab everything important and let's move. Dragon's burning everything to the ground.
I just need to gather some more potions.
Nah, man, that's not a good use of your time. Let's try out this magic, whatever that means. That's my Nord voice. That's a lot of damage on adept difficulty when we're not a mage. Bye-bye, Imperial Soldier. What do you have for me, my friend? That's not good. But as usual, I like to grab all of this stuff until we get pretty close to our carry weight. We're looking for a two-handed sword. That's what we really want.
See if you can find any potions. We'll need them.
Oh, I can. I got one right now. What do you think of that, Rayloff? And one right there. And a salt pile. You like salt, Rayloff? I like salt quite a bit. Too much, even. Gotta watch out for your salt intake. It's not healthy. And also, guys get kidney stones. Apparently, the most painful thing a guy could experience. Luckily, I've never ran into that, even though I'm a big fan of fast food and eating terribly. I do go to the gym and eat healthy most of the week, though, to offset that, but I do love my fast food quite a bit. Anyways, in the barrels, we have some potions. Boom, boom. Thank you very much. We'll put all of our stuff away so we can move a little tiny bit faster, I believe. And let's grab that, and let's grab that. We've all seen this, so I want to actually see the majority of Skyrim. So I think for the rest of this dungeon, we will just run through this. If you guys have not seen all of these little interactions, well, I luckily have a let's play that you can check out. It's the biggest let's play I've ever done, and it involves most, if not all, of these little interactions here. We're gonna take this, and then there was a burp that escaped me, and then I am going to, bye-bye, torturer's assistant. You did not last. An iron mace, huh? Okay, that's an upgrade by one damage. We'll go ahead and equip that. And then we're looking again for something that we can utilize as a Nord. Also, we have healing activated, so let's do that. That doesn't heal us for jack shit. That's a 10 damage mace. Isn't that an upgrade? I think the one that we have right now is... oh, they're both 10. Okay, well, we'll grab the shield, and then we will... oh, he gives us... he gives us 12 lockpicks? Yeah, there's some extra ones over here, but we mostly know that. Okay, let's go ahead and do this. Why not? All right. Yeah, we'll take a look at everything pretty much in this game and see how it's been changed. You probably see the dynamic here so far. Everything just looks better, obviously. I mean, that was how it's going to go anyway. But, yeah, just like, you know, the lock picking, how the lock actually looks different and stuff like that. No game mechanics have been changed, I don't think. I would be surprised if the game mechanics have been changed in any way, especially significantly. All right, let's move on. Now, normally I would loot all of these cells to the left and to the right to gain some lock picking experience. But I want to get out of this to tunnel as fast as possible so I can show you guys the good stuff. All right, so into the actual to tunnel. But I don't want to move too fast either, because I want you guys to see, like I said, all of the differences. And this is me experiencing the differences for myself as well. Let's grab flames and let's use our power in here. We'll use Battle Cry. One of the cooler effects. And then we can, of course, hit them as they run away. Oh, and there should be some oil on the ground. That's right. I forgot about that. Oh, is the guy going to get away? Well, the guy to the left didn't. Sorry, I'm all out of mercy. Got a large supply of death, though. Let's see. We'll take the longbow, even though I think we'll find one in the next room. We'll take your arrows, and still no two-handed weapons, unfortunately. Let's use a power attack on this guy, and nice arrow from Rayloff there. I grabbed another bow by accident. We're getting pretty close to our carry weight now. Moving on. Oh, I know victory's mine. Here, I'll get the... the little walkway for you.
Not so fast.
And adios, muchacho. Oh yeah, let's take a look at what we look like, by the way. How do we do that? Back. Clicking the right stick, putting our weapon away. Put our weapon away so we can turn it around. There we go. Looking like a true, well, Imperial, not a Nord. Let's loot this guy and see if he has anything. Boom. And still no two-handed. We'll find one. Not sure whether or not I want to use an axe or if I want to use a two-handed sword. You know what? A battle axe sounds good. I think I'll go for the battle axe. Let's go back here. We'll find that coin purse and the skeleton and the potion. Always usually do that. Let's take a little bit out of our way. If we were to go back over there, it would show us the bridge that collapsed or something. So we're going to keep continuing. Take out our mace. And let's see. We have another coin purse here. And we will continue in the Totora Tunnel. Like I said, we're going to be completely exploring. So this is going to be completely different than my normal Let's Play. Than the Let's Play on the channel. Because we are going to be doing whatever I want to do, pretty much. And that should be pretty fun. We've been poisoned. Let's grab some Frostbite Venom from these guys. We have a bunch of potions, though. Really? There was only like one or two that had those? Okay, in the meantime, we'll expend our Magicka to kill one of these. And then we'll go into items, potions, frostbite venom, and apply that. Actually, I just realized it shouldn't really affect the... Oh, wow, that really affects them. Oh, okay. He just wanted to fall through the floor, I guess. You would think they'd be immune to their own frostbite venom. How does that make sense? I don't know, but anyways, we're going to move on. Okay, let's see. Which room is this? Aha, this is the room where Rayloff tells us to be very, very quiet. But we're a Nord, and I don't think Nords are really known for being quiet. Are they? I saw a helmet over there, which we'll check out in a second. For now, let's light this bear on fire. And I think... Wow, how did we execute that bear that early when he had that much health? I don't really know. Anyways, we'll put that away and we'll go back over here and look at all the goodies that we missed out on. There is the iron helmet, the dragonborn helmet, if you will. And there's a coin purse in there. I want to grab it. And got it. Okay, I was mulling over some ideas to do with my time with the early release of Skyrim Special Edition, and I came across some ideas. I was going to speed run the game, you know, try and speed run it and just get as far as humanly possible in whatever direction, guilds or the main quest. I was going to create myself and call the first title GV Plays With Himself. That would have been funny, huh? And then do everything based on what I would actually do. Let's take a look at the loading screen time. Exiting to actual Skyrim. Okay, that's vastly improved.
Wait.
There he goes. Looks like he's gone for good this time. No way to know if anyone else made it out alive. But this place is going to be swarming with Imperials soon enough. We better clear out of here. My sister, Gerder, runs the mill in Riverwoods, just up the road. I'm sure she'd help you out.
It's probably best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help today.
All right, and take a look, ladies and gentlemen. This is a clear improvement. Of course it is. It's a re-release of a game, but I'm just saying, yes, this is definitely very, very, very noticeable. Everything just looks, like I said, so much smoother, so much more beautiful. Really, really, really nice. I wonder how the PC version is going to compare. I am not sure, but I am going to have it, and for those unaware, I will be transitioning the Let's Play over to it once it comes out officially on the 27th. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and begin our complete exploration of Skyrim, the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim Special Edition, which, if you were unaware, also comes with all of the DLCs and completely remastered graphics. As you can see, everything is far more beautiful. Now, I think one of the best things about Skyrim, especially when I first started playing it on November 11th, 2011, was just the serene feeling that you get. I mean, everything is so nice when you first start off. Look at this. The graphics are amazing. They were really a milestone. What is that? An achievement? Oh, yeah, that's right. There's new achievements. Complete Unbound. Very nice. That was such a hard achievement to do. Yes, just the serene feeling. I remember having so many fond memories of playing this game when it first came out. Just awesome. Just an entirely new world to explore. It was overwhelming for me. I was like, where do I even begin?
These are the Guardian Stones, three of the 13 ancient standing stones that dot Skyrim's landscape. Go ahead, see for yourself.
Was that added?
Warrior, good. Those stars will guide you to honor and glory.
Was that added, that piece of dialogue with Rayloff there? I don't remember him ever saying that. And if you travel out here with Hadvar, I don't remember him ever saying that either. I wonder if you just have to be near him when that happens. Are you waiting for me to enter Riverwood? I guess we'll find Riverwood. Unless we want to clear out Ember Shard Mine again. I think that was the first thing that we did with Adrenok, and it shouldn't be too hard. It'll give us a little boost, and we can see how the mine differs from the previous time. Let's see if Rayloff has anything to say about it. Anything to say about Ember Shard?
Remember, this isn't Stormcloak territory. If we're ahead of the news from Helgen,
yeah, that's great. I'm really not sure. I mean, honestly, if they're making a re-release of a game, they probably would add in some dialogue lines or some game mechanics. I really don't know. We'll see as far as we can get.
You're mine.
Actually, you're mine. But thanks for trying, friend. Do you have a two-handed battle axe by any chance? Hide armor, hide boots, and a steel sword. You do not. Piece of crap. Alright, yes, let's go ahead and clear out Ember Shard Mine. I suggest this for new players of the game. It's such a low-level, easy mine to clear out, and it's a really fitting place to find out how Skyrim's dungeons work and how handcrafted they are and awesome. Let's push that down there, just because I want to. Does that actually do anything? There's no bandit enemies near here, are there? There's a tripwire, though. It's a pretty complex trap there to rely on a simple tripwire. Who would have thought a Nord wearing huge heavy armor is not sneaky at all? Dang. Wow, we're getting all of the executions. I wonder if the difficulty was changed whatsoever. Steel war axe, that is better than a stinking mace. But we still need... ooh, and an amulet of Stendar. Block 10% more damage with your shield. Not really useful for us, but we'll equip it anyways. Yes, we still need a two-handed weapon as soon as possible so we can start accruing... oh, we'll take the pickaxe. Ooh, I never realized that's a nice beginning area to grab yourself a pickaxe. Yes, to start accruing points towards the two-handed skill tree. Let's see, this guy should have a journal down here. Yes, indeed. I've read it on the... yeah, just look at this. Everything, the lighting is so much better. Everything just looks more realistic. It's definitely different from the PC version, even with the high-resolution texture packs added. The official DLC, only available for the PC version. It looks different. It definitely looks better. It looks like you have some graphical shaders installed or something. Did I switch the right stick to sneak? I feel like I did. So let's go into settings so I can show you guys that as well. Or actually controls. And then sneak should be the right stick. I'm pretty sure that's how I have it set up in Skyrim because this feels right now. Yeah, because I think they changed it in Fallout 4. Okay, let's kill these guys. This is what I want. Yeah, I want you to die. Oh, this guy has a two-handed sword. Hell yeah, dude. Thank you so much. You have made my job so much easier. Iron Greatsword, we're going to go ahead and equip that. You were carrying too much to be able to run, I figured, so let's drop some crappy weapons. Let's see, we'll store all of the Imperial Swords. Where's our carry weight at? Okay, that's pretty good. And we'll store the Iron Maces, and we'll keep everything else. And now we have a two-handed weapon, which means we can start increasing our two-handed, which is what this guy is going to use. We're still going to be looking for a battle axe, though. Only Skyrim pros can make that jump. It's an advanced technique. Don't try it, guys. Please don't try it. It won't work out too well. All right, so is this telekinesis? No, it is clairvoyance. No one is there. Don't worry about it. Do not worry about it. Actually, show yourself to me so I can murder you. Now you're mine? Yeah, looks like I took out most of your health. What do you feel about that, huh? Guess I don't really care, do I? Let's put that away and grab ourselves all of this gold. Don't mind if I do. Oh, we've got an iron greatsword and an iron warhammer. Let's go ahead and use the warhammer over the greatsword and compare the damage. So iron greatsword is 17, warhammer is 20, but obviously it's going to be slower. But we will equip that. We're getting closer and closer to our axe, though. Corundum, gold, silver ring, and iron war axe of sparks. Not too bad. Let's continue to clear out this location, shall we? Oh, I remember this one. Yes, this is the big open area. I'll take the coin purse. We'll have to remember that there's some beds over there. Let's use... Do we not have battle cry? It hasn't been a day, has it? No battle cry for us. That's okay. I agree. Time to end this little game. With one fell swoop of my iron battle axe. Jeez. I feel very bad for you, my friend, but I don't really. Let's get rid of the tutorial messages for the forging. Mm-hmm, that's quite interesting. Wow. Such a great dungeon to start off with, honestly. It just has everything inside of it. It has a pickaxe for you to grab. It has combat. It has an entire blacksmithing area. It has a light armor or smithing book. Is that going to be a level up? Indeed it is. The first level for Mr. Surge. Let's go ahead and do that. Magicka, health, or stamina? Let's go with health. We're obviously going to be focusing on health and stamina. And let's find two-handed. There we are. Two-handed weapons do 20% more damage. Sounds good to me. So that all looked pretty similar, obviously. I don't think they changed anything. They might have made some bug changes. I'm not really sure what they did in addition to the graphics. I looked at the back of the game, the box, just to see what the description was. And it doesn't sound like they added... It doesn't sound like they even mentioned there were any bug increases or bug decreases or bug fixes or game mechanic changes or anything. I will double check as I'm editing this in case I'm wrong. But yeah, I think it's mainly just a graphical increase. You can see starting off as a two-handed warrior, you do so much damage right off the bat that you just, even on adept difficulty, you flat out just one-hit kill a lot of people, which is pretty nice. But the Warhammer is slow, so you have to make your shots count, obviously. All right, nothing in here. I know there was like a hidden chest somewhere through here, though. It's probably right through here. This will lead us to the hidden chest, I think. We've got an ore vein. Ah, there we are, and a coin purse. This is a novice lock. No worries. Boom goes the dynamite. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We'll take some stamina potions. I always say I never take them, but every now and then I actually could utilize some. All right, and let's exit Ember Shard Mine. Oh, but we can't exit without dragging the body. Oh, you're so heavy. You're so heavy. Oh, no. Are you really too heavy for me to drag over? Oh, there we go. In you go. Such a satisfying plunge into the water there. Alrighty, let's exit Ember Shard Mine. I think we'll activate Riverwood just so we have some sort of base. That looks kind of different. The exits, huh? The lighting looks a lot better. Yes, I think we'll explore or we'll find Riverwood just so we have a base of operations, but then we will do our own thing. It exits you right back at the start of Riverwood anyways, as if to say, hey, that was cool, wasn't it? The more exploratory players just got a great experience. And if not, well, you just went to Riverwood. What's funny is I think I just went to Riverwood for my first time. I don't think I ever explored Ember Shard Mine for a very, very long time. And here, ladies and gentlemen, is none other than good old Riverwood. look at it for a few seconds. We of course have this exchange here. We'll see how it differs a bit.
It was as big as the mountain and black as night. It flew right over the barrel.
Dragons now, is it? Please, Mother. If you keep on like this, everyone in town will think you're crazy. And I've got better things to do than listen to more of your fantasies.
Come on. You'll see. It was a dragon. It'll kill us all, and then you'll believe me.
I believe you, Hilda. I believe you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to end this episode here. Thank you guys so much for watching. Again, thank you to Bethesda for sending me this game early. I hope you guys are enjoying the series. If you are, please leave a like and subscribe if you want to see more. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.